Asian Paints is the only business in the history of mankind which has witnessed a revenue growth of 20% per annum for 6 consecutive decades. The company went public in the year 1982, and since then it has given a return of over 1800 times. Now, keeping these facts in mind, the question is, how does Asian Paints mint so much money? Before we move ahead, if you like our content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay tuned for more videos like these. In our last video, we left you with the thought of Asian Paints being a large data conglomerate, probably as big as Google or even Facebook. Now, let's understand how it is actually a data giant. The year is 1969, business is doing well, but Mr. Choksi isn't very satisfied with how things are turning out to be. Now, an FMCG product has various channels of distribution such as a wholesaler and a retailer before the product reaches the consumer. Until the year 1969, that is how paints were being sold. On a bright Monday morning on the summer of 69, Choksi ji called up his distributors and wholesalers and asked them to clear out all the stock that they had and cut themselves off of Asian Paints supply chain because Choksi ji wanted to sell directly to the shopkeeper. Now, in a situation like this, the local shopkeeper should have been happy as they would get more business, but in this case, they started protesting. Well, it is a little absurd to think since Asian Paints was clearly doing them a favor by helping them earn more money with higher margins. There were primarily two reasons behind why they were protesting. One being that their shops were small and did not have enough space to stock up so much paint. Second, to maintain such a large stock, local shopkeepers didn't have sufficient capital, and this made it hard for them to procure or order paint and even sell it. The dealers then requested Choksi ji to at least let the distributors be there in the supply chain as they could take care of the storing and financing. But as Saurabh Mukherjee says in his book Unusual Billionaires, at the heart of all money-making machines in India lies a non-linear site, which at that time looks like pure madness and 30 years later looks like an undiluted genius. Choksi ji's non-linear moment was the summer of 69 when he fired the distributors and told the dealers that he will restock their inventory every 3 hours, and in that case, the dealers wouldn't have to worry about the stocking and financing. People in Mumbai called him foolish and started questioning his ideologies and said that every 3 hours of restocking means delivering 4 times a day and you have 40,000 dealers. How on earth will you deliver 1.6 lakh times a day? The remaining 28 years of his life, Champaklal Choksi built something that no one in their right mind can even think of building. And today, 22 years after his death, Asian Paints is one of the most successful companies in the history of mankind. Asian Paints is the only company in India which manages to restock their distributors 4 times a day or 28 times a week. All other FMCG goods like biscuits, soaps and even chips get restocked probably twice or maximum thrice a week. And most of the other companies across various industries take around 50 to 60% of the MRP value as their revenue, and the rest goes into the channels of distribution. Can you guess how much of the MRP value Asian Paints takes home as revenue? 97%. Yes, you heard it right, 97% of the MRP value is taken home by Asian Paints and the rest goes to the dealer. Today, Asian Paints has 70,000 dealers who they deliver to 4 times a day. That's 2.8 lakh times a day. The second biggest paint company, Berger Paints, delivers 40,000 times a day. With these numbers, we can clearly see the monopoly Asian Paints has built over the last few decades. It is safe to say that there is no company in any industry in India that has the audacity to compete with the optimized structure and financials of Asian Paints. You might wonder how Asian Paints delivers 2.8 lakh times a day in a country like India, given its poor infrastructure. The answer is technology. In the year 1970, Choksi ji purchased the first supercomputer in India for Rs. 8 crores. That is 10 years before ISRO and IIT Delhi and 20 years before most of the big Indian conglomerates. Now, what Asian Paints has done in simple words is that for every neighborhood in India, for every hour of the day, for 50 years, they have collected data on what colors are selling, what quantities are selling, which area has more demand and so on. This mountain of data is their money-making formula, and it is solely because of this reason that Asian Paints, as mentioned in our previous video, can predict which paint will sell where, in what quantity and what time with almost 97% accuracy. Now, the entire system of their working capital cycle is automated, from raw materials to cash coming into the bank. Asian Paints has a working capital cycle of 8 days. Yes, only 8 days. from raw materials to cash in the bank in just 8 days. Berger Paints, which posts only one-third of Asian Paints' revenue, has a working capital cycle of 45 days, and Akzo Nobel, which has the best quality of paint in India, has a working capital cycle of over 100 days. Now, because of this, every day Asian Paints sells to 55% of the country, 4 times a day, which is 220 times. Berger Paints sells to 20% of the country twice a day, so that is just 40 times. And Akzo sells to 10% of the country once a day, basically 10 times. You can clearly see, every day Asian Paints collects 5 to 20 times more data than any other company in the country. And this in turn refines their system even further as they collect more and more data. Quite amusing, right? Well, I guess what they say is coming out to be true, that data is the new oil. The more data you have, the higher your chances are to lead in the market.